Hello guys, this is Rupesh and you are watching CVP Nerds video series on string related interview question series, and this is pangram, like check if it is pangram or not. So you will be given some string, let's say, and you have to check that if this string is pangram or not. So let's see what is pangram first. So pangram meaning, if there is a string, then it should contain all the characters of alphabets. It can be big A, it can be smaller, or the combination, doesn't matter. And this string can be very big, or at least 26 characters. I mean, it can go below 26 characters. If it is like that, then for sure it is not a pangram. So if you consider this is your given string, then you can see that if you pause the video and count, you will find that it is having all the characters from alphabet. And I told you, like, this T can be a capital T, and that would still be considered. So it is like combination of capital and small letter should include all the characters. Now let's talk about the implementation part here. You know that this string what we have here, it can be very big string, and the solution what we are looking for is like order of n. So what we are going to do is, first of all, we know that we have 26 characters to deal with, right? So I can assume an array or a vector with 0 to 25, right? And I can fill all the values here false. Initially, we'll put every element as false. And we can map like A to Z. We know that it is 26 characters. We can map A to 0 and Z to 25. How we are going to do that? Actually, it's very simple. Whatever the character you have, let's say T. T minus small a, if you calculate this, this is going to give you the index of this T in this array or vector. So for simplicity, if you take B, so B minus a is equal to what? We know this is going to get calculated in ASCII. So B's ASCII is 98. Minus A's ASCII is 97 is going to be 1, and B will be indexed at first position. And similarly A, so A minus A is 0, so A will be here. So this is how you will map it, and doesn't matter if it is small or capital. The only point is you have to check each and every character if it is capital letter or small letter. If it is capital letter, then you have to do this minus element with the capital now, and then you will find the result. So if it is capital, you'll use this formula. If it is small, we will use this formula. So let's quickly see the program. So this is your lead code. This is the question. And here we have the solution. I told you, right, we can use array or vector. I have taken this vector name flag. It will be of 26 size, and all will be initialized with false for the beginning. And then we have this for loop. We'll iterate over this sentence, whatever we get here, iterate over it. And we'll just check if this element is small. So this is for small, okay? And obviously this is for capital. So we know flag is initialized with false, and then we'll just simply do this true initialization. And this is the formula, E minus small a, if it is, I mean the E is small, otherwise this formula. And once we are done with the full sentence, we can check like flag is left with any false, because we will iterate over flags, and if it is having any false in any of the index, then we'll just return false. If we don't hit any false here, then we are going to obviously return true. So this is the solution, but we have another quicker way. Just check if sentence dot length is greater than or equal to, or for simplicity we can say less than 26, then we will return false. You know why I'm doing this? If your strings are like very small, why would you, I mean very small meaning, if your string length is at least not 26, then it is not possible that it can be a pangram, because in order to be a pangram, all the 26 characters should exist in the string. So let me just run this. I have already run this, and so this is accepted. Okay, good. So this is accepted. So string questions are like very important in the interviews, because it is really very easy to check the logic of the candidate. So thanks for watching, guys. Bye bye. Take care. I'll see you in the next videos.